Okay, welcome back once more to Let's Play Psychonauts. See, last time we finished up the asylum, and now all of the other kids are rebrained, so we're going to do the final round of talk to everybody in this game. I do plan on finishing up the whole thing tonight, so we're just gonna keep going until it ends. Oh, some of these kids we've already talked to, but now we have something else we can do with them. Mr. Pokelope, if you played the game, just going straight forward through it, you would have him for like 2 seconds and then you would give him back to Shigor. But instead, if you bring him back to here, you will find just how much Double Fine made sure that every dang thing in the game can be shown around.
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Lope. Better keep that little head tucked away until we give the all clear.
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
Better go put that little guy somewhere safe. There's a war on right now, you know.
Yeah. Most people are concerned about the fact that Raz is dragging around a little helpless turtle.
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
My dad bought me a bigger turtle than that for my birthday.
You wouldn't think that Kitty would be the type of person who would want a turtle for her birthday.
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
Glad you finally got a friend.
Than we haven't talked to before. So
and so I'm really sorry for not believing you. Right, yeah, that too. I should really not have blown so many of you up. I just get so confused sometimes.
Hey, wanna help me save the world?
Well, this could take a while. They're really mad.
You can't really blame them for being really mad when he's been running around killing them for trying to warn them of what, for trying to warn him about what the coach is up to.
No, I can't mess around with Mr. Pokelope. I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
Hi, I like your hat.
If there is a hat to be found, Dogen will like it. Everybody's hats are cool to him.
Hey, want to help me save the world?
Well, to tell you the truth, Earthling, this world is a goner. Right now, I'm just trying to hitch a ride to the next one over.
You weren't who I was trying to
Hey, want to help me save the world?
That's what we're doing, duh! Chloe has some friends who she's calling, who are gonna kick the coach's ass!
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
Turtles are stupid!
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
You know, turtles are just visitors from another galaxy who never left. Their shells are actually atmospheric re-entry heat shields.
Everyone knows that.
Like I said when it first came up, Bobby's little crush on Chloe is about the only humanizing thing about him. He is still a little jerk, but it is cute that he likes the space girl.
Two would get back together.
I know. Isn't it just too romantic? I just hope James won't be too crushed.
Shh. You promised. No talking.
Hey, wanna help me save the world?
Kinda busy.
Hey, wanna help me save the world?
Can't you see we're too busy being in love?
Like I've said throughout the game, Tap's relationship is going to crash and burn, and it's just horrible.
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
Oh, Mr. Pokelope. I wish I had a hard shell like yours around my heart.
Kiddo, you're way too young to be that jaded.
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
Mister? Don't you have any female friends you could introduce me to?
Pig!
And the band is back together.
Hey, wanna help me save the world?
Nah, I feel pretty good letting you take care of that.
I'm sure you got that under control. I gotta practice for the big celebration afterwards.
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
Okay, Mr. Turtle. This next song is going out to you.
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
Hey, little turtle. Careful with that crown if you do any stage diving, okay?
Oof.
Sorry, Vernon.
Hey, wanna help me save the world?
Not now, Raz. I'm trying to finish writing my memoirs before we all die.
Now, he is supposed to be writing down the story of what has happened at the camp this summer, but they didn't bother swapping out the picture that Milka was drawing earlier on in the game where he's sitting, so it looks like now he is the one with a crush on Elton.
Oh, man. Gotta work a little turtle with a crown into the story somehow. Maybe he can be my little wisecracking sidekick.
Sure, what story wouldn't it be better with a little turtle with a crown in it? Run. Go away, cougar. I'm not getting set on fire by you. Now, Mikhail and Maloof, the only two who are doing something that could actually turn out helpful.
Now wire the other end to the gas tank. Oh, hello, Rasputin.
What are you guys doing?
Taking care of business. The fewer questions you ask, the better.
Hi again, Crab Man.
Hey, wanna help me save the world?
We are. This is how we handle things in my family.
Family.
I wonder if the coach has a little jetpack or something to help him get in and out of this thing. I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
Seems like a nice turtle. You shouldn't get him involved in this mess, Raz.
On here.
I wonder if the coach has a little jetpack really or something to help him get in and out of this thing.
Jump, jump, jump. Now we'll go see Crystal and Clem bugging the hell out of poor Janitor Cruller. Enemy.
Listen, you gotta help. You gotta kill me, son. I can't take the cheering anymore.
I'm sorry I put their brains back. Maybe a bear will get them soon.
Maybe. If not, you gotta find my drain cleaner and pour it down my throat, okay?
Yay, Mr. Cruller!
It is a bit mean to be talking about the two suicidal kids that way right in front of them.
Hey, wanna help me save the world?
Hey, if there's one thing the world needs, it's cheer!
Cheerleaders save the world one smile at a time!
Yay! Won't
you help?
Woo-hoo!
I'm a janitor! Let me know when somebody drops a carton of eggs or something.
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
Three cheers for Mr. Pokelope!
Hip hip hooray!
Hip hip hooray!
Hip hip hooray!
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokelope.
Three cheers for Mr. Pokelope!
Hip hip hooray!
Hip hip hooray!
Hip hip hooray!
Mop! Mop! Mop!
You really can't blame Cruller for going nuts about the two of them. They are super annoying. Nice kids, but annoying. No! I can't remember if there's actually any kids in the GPC, but there is one thing I have to do down here. That is finally turn in the last of my scavenger hunt sheet.
Mr. Crowley, you gotta help. Kids are getting kidnapped and everyone's missing, and their brains are stolen. And I think the coach is trying to take over the world with psychically armed death tanks.
Well, now, you see what happens when you go to parts of the force that are off limits?
Won't you help?
I'm a ranger. I got enough problems wrangling these leaves. Now get!
Ta-da! I'm done. I completed the whole scavenger hunt.
Great. Odin's right. I don't think anyone's ever done the whole thing before. Well, hold still. This might hurt.
Yeah, like I pointed out when we are up the watch, it makes sense that nobody's ever done the whole thing before when one of them was way over at the asylum, so it was actually impossible for them to beat it if they actually followed camp's rules.
That felt good.
Congratulations! Now get!
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokilo.
Hello, Mr. Pokilope. Would you please tell your friend that these woods are off limits?
Okay, you don't want to jump on their ass? Yeah, I don't think there were any kids in here. On to the beach.
Hey, want to help me save the world?
Later.
At least she's not invisible this time.
Hey, want to help me save the world?
Later.
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokilo.
Hi.
It is just odd that Elton is the one who gets more makeout scenes than anybody else in this game. Of course, considering they're all, like, 8 to 12, it's odd that any of them have makeout scenes.
People are missing, kids' brains have been stolen.
That's not what I wanted to do.
I'd like you to meet Mr. Pokilope.
Greetings, Mr. Pokilope. Stay away from the canoes, and we won't have any problems. Understand?
You and your canoes, Admiral, sir.
Chops, buddy. If you...
Okay, let's get back out into the field.
Where would you like me to take you, Agent Kreller?
Let's go to Ford's... my sanctuary.
Yes, noble Psycho Master.
And because I am super, super dumb, I am going to have to climb the whole asylum again. If you weren't here watching yesterday, I missed one of the brains, went down to get it, and forgot to think, you know, it would be a lot smarter to take down the express elevator and then climb back up to get it instead of going down from the top and not having a shortcut left. The only thing I can hope for is that, since the game knows I've been to the top of the asylum, potentially Ford's teleportation will take me back there. If I'm very, very lucky, he doesn't always drop you right off at where you left off. But I don't think that's gonna happen.
Agent Kreller?
What is the current situation?
Oops, top one.
I'm ready to go back into the field.
Okay, let's see if I remember exactly where you were.
And if you notice I didn't talk to Benny, that is because Benny is nowhere to be found after getting rebrained. But then he did say that he was going to go off and try to become Coach's little lickspittle, so... The at least this time, running it will be pretty fast, since I don't have to dodge around getting everybody's brains and everything. I can just go straight up. No, not that way. And we don't have to worry about putting on a costume anymore since Crispin's gone. Oh, I hate you, mice. Rats. That's not what I was trying to do. That's not where I'm going. La da da da. And of course, having to climb the whole tower again means having to deal with those damn rats again. These really are just my absolute least favorite enemies in the game. Though I'm sure lots of people would say the exact same thing there. Oh yeah, he does, I know, show up in the containment room sometimes, doesn't he? But it's randomly happens, so I've never seen it. I have heard that, though. I just didn't know for sure if it was actually true or if it was one of those video game rumors that happens. Brain's not working. That's right, up here. You'll notice that when you're coming back up again, Shigor is no longer shrieking at you as long as you've already met her up there. So no little bubbles voice. Yeah, let's get down here instead of trying to make it from there. I always love the design of this asylum, even though it's nuts. Oops. And that was not brilliant of me. It just gets so weird as you go on. Actually, it triggers my vertigo just a little bit. No, Raz, don't jump off the bed. There we go. I did top off on Dream Fluffs before, starting up my Let's Play this time, though, so if they do manage to blow me up too many times, I'm not in trouble. Supposed to grab that, Raz. Oh, fine. I'll do it the right way. Sure. Are you, you horrible squeaky thing? I hear them, but I have no idea where they're at. So like I said, it's not nearly as long to go through it now since I'm mostly done with stuff, but it is still annoying that I have to do all this backtracking because I was a dumbass. But then I couldn't remember where the brain that I missed was at, so I was hoping that it was going to be near the top where I wouldn't have to go down too far. Coming up on me, jeez.
Ugh.
Just minding my own business, waiting for the fog of confusion goo to clear up. You are not doing that great at jumping for me today. There we go. Oh yeah, that's where I'm supposed to go. I don't know why some of those things are only climbable on one side. Yep. So I know from being a child it is totally possible to climb upside down off of a sloped jungle gymmy thing. So it'll freak out any teachers who are watching. Wait, I already jumped the bird. I don't need to be invisible. What am I doing? So now this is it. We're going into the point of return in just a minute. Point of no return in just a minute. That right there is the express elevator that I would have taken if I was not a dumbass, if you never played this game before.
Everything's gonna be all right. Now, here's what we're gonna do.
I'll get to it right after I'm done with this experiment.
Okay.
Don't worry, baby. Just make sure I get put in that old tank, and Daddy will take care of business.
I can't watch!
you're wondering how a little turtle has a brain that big, the explanation is that he's one of the mutated animals from the camp. And in actuality, his brain takes up his entire shell. And that is why he is such a clever little turtle.
Excellent. There it is. Good work, Shigor. All we have to do is get it in the brain tank somehow.
But that does beg the question of what exactly is in his skull if his brain is kept underneath the shell.
If we could just get my careful there now. It's time to make the soup.
So for all that he's built up to the game, you never fight Lobata yourself.
Please, Pokilo, please, my king! La, 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 everything!
Nice and easy.
But Rasputin, recranialization of an adult brain without surgery is...
That's a very advanced procedure. How did you know how to do it?
Well, I've studied a little. But Shigor here knows more about handling brains than anyone I've ever met.
Really? You know I've been thinking about getting a lab assistant.
Shigor, darling, do you know where all of the other children's brains are?
Well, if you can lead us to them, we can bring them back to their owners immediately.
Ahem!
Immediately after we break young Ms. Zanotto here out of her restraints.
So that was just a little reassurance that if you've been lazy through the game, this part of the game, and haven't grabbed everybody's brains, the kids are still going to be safe. Shigor will go and return them to all of them.
Rasputin. Instead of that, why don't you help me free Mrs. Zanotto?
That's nice, darling, but why don't you help us instead?
Rasputin, instead of that, why don't you help me free Mrs. Zanotto?
Raz,
Mia,
come on,
let's try it without the Omega phasing.
Now, you can stand there watching them shoot all day, but the two superstar Psychonauts are completely unable to break through there on their own.
Coach Oleander's gonna burn.
At least he never got inside your brain. It's gonna take me weeks to get my rhythm back.
Rasputin, you have surprised us yet again. I cannot thank you enough for what you've done.
Hey, all in a day's work for a Psychonaut.
Well, Psy-cadet, you mean.
Hey, the Psychonauts should be so lucky to get someone like Raz. The brain he's got in there
is one in a million. Thanks to all of you for bringing it straight to my door!
Oleander.
You! You took all my friends' brains. You turned an innocent fish into a giant monster. You stole all the teachers, derailing my education. And you kidnapped my girlfriend.
Rasputin, this fight is too big for you.
Back home, I had to clean up after the elephants, so trust me. I know how to take care of this ugly little pile of...
Kids, let the grown-ups handle this.
You tall people!
Sasha!
We get to kill him too!
Well, it's official. The genius is back. Time to go get ready for my Garrity show. Uh-oh, this looks bad. Ah, well, that's good. Someone must have turned off the gas long ago.
Oh, here's what my poor flowers need. A little water.
Oh no, I spilled all my turpentine and acetone.
Boyd, long time no see.
Oh, Mr. Orderly, I did not see you there. I was just taking a little therapeutic walk in the moonlight.
Relax, the asylum's closed. We can all go home.
Leave? Here?
Yeah, this place is for crazy people. And I don't know about you, but I ain't crazy no more.
I have to tell you, I'm feeling pretty good.
You know, maybe it is time for us all to move on.
What do you think, Boyd? You ready to blow this popsicle stand?
The milkman has completed his route. You guys want to split a cab?
And the crib wasn't even that clean. I mean, what do I have to do to get those guys to take me seriously?
When are you going to shut up and kiss me?
I can hear that.
I know.
Surrender!
Never!
The Psychonauts have a word for people who turn on their own.
Ha! I don't need the Psychonauts anymore. I'm making my own army. Got a word for that?
Yeah. Gesundheit!
Huh?
Wow.
Wow. My fight. I was ready for that one.
Always in such a rush, Rasputin. It takes years before you're ready for combat of that magnitude.
Well, you'd be surprised, Nine. This one's been acing all my extra credit exams.
I beat the coach once already, and I can do it again.
Darling, that was just a remote projection of the coach. He wasn't as strong as he would be if he were to appear in the real world.
TV? TV?
Where's his brain?
Oh, probably stuck in one of his plans to take over the world somewhere.
Hey! How's the weather down there? Ah, finally. Alone at last, eh, Rasputin?
Glad you're finally picking on someone your own size.
Yes, I've been dying for a chance to pick your brain!
Two can play that game.
Yeah, but only one can win.
One you don't try fighting by any conventional means. Oops. Because he's built this big old wall here, you have to just keep chucking stuff around with telepathy. I was trying to get on my levitation ball there before that threw, but...
Whoa.
of this fight is all throwing crap around and trying not to get hit by the blocks that he throws back at you.
Can't get a good grip.
Space, but oops. Controls are not helping me. Big fuck up on Sasha and Mia's and Ford's part. Not stopping to think that the dude has a psychic death tank up in his lab that you have already used once yourself. And if you're wondering how Ford was able to get out of there with his mental issues, if you keep an eye on the cutscene, you'll see that he has a giant hunk of titanium strapped onto his back. Though, I just noticed for the first time that they actually mess up in when he comes down to the courtyard and everybody's, you know, goofing around after the fight for a second. They forgot to animate it in there, which could explain why he was joining in on the stupidity of not stopping to think that he has a psychic death tank. Where did I put my pop?
Yeah! Super! Sneezing! Powder! Ugh! Try not to sneeze! Have to hold it in!
Oh, this is just great. Now what am I going to do? Have to think. Like I got a choice.
How the coach's brain managed to hold on to sneezing powder is beyond me. Actually, it could be the same way that Raz is able to hold on to himself here. At this point, your options are really limited. You can use some of your psychic abilities, but not most of them. So your goal now is just to chuck yourself in and attack Coach's brain. And Coach has a really fucking huge brain.
Call me Mori or Oli.
Coach Oleander? What are you doing in my mind?
How did you get in my happy meadow? Nobody's supposed to know about it. You didn't tell my dad about it, did you? Oh, that's him! Oh no! Come on, little bunny! We'll be safe in here!
So now we are about to enter the infamous meat circus. This is the level that drives people nuts so much that in the Steam version they made it a little bit easier. Actually, I should have left that on. Maybe one day I'll get a capture card and show y'all how it is in the original PlayStation version. This is actually going to be my first time playing the final level on Steam instead of on PlayStation, so we will see how the changes go. I think it's mostly supposed to be little Oli used to have a pretty quickly depleting life bar, and if he got hurt, or if he died, you were screwed. And what was the other thing? I think it was something else, but I can't remember what.
Okay. The circus I remember from my childhood was definitely not made of meat. The last time I checked.
Right here, we finally learn Rasputin's last name as part of the Aquatos. There wasn't confirmation that that actually is his last name until, like, a year or two ago. Until then, it was people guessed it, but we didn't sure. And you'll notice everybody is marked with whether they're alive or dead. Apparently, the world's skinniest guy is dead, as is Kid Lasagna. Alligator Boy is alive, but mad? Is that the Galiceos are the people who cursed Raz's family to die in water. They are apparently all dead. His family is still alive. Minus those who have died in water. And now, instead of actually going into the final level, let's go... Yes, the PlayStation was crazy. Though it does make you really, really proud once you've, played the game enough that you can get through it relatively okay. At this point, you can see that the brain tumbler is gone. Earlier in the game, if you're in the collective unconsciousness, you could use that as a shortcut to Sasha's lab. Now, it's not only gone, but you can fall right off of the edge of the collective unconsciousness from its platform. But anyway, I'm going to go show you what the after stuff is for each of the inmates' minds, minus Edgar, who I already showed.
Boy?
Not much to do here except clean up all the cobwebs, collect all the figments, and get any vaults that are left.
So, Boyd, there's not much going on in his mind now. Just the Milkman endlessly attacking sensors that are trying to stop him. You'd think that at this point... that he would be, cleared out because you saw Boyd's
must make final delivery.
Mental figments delusions leaving his head in the final cutscene, but can't really blame him warm. For not wanting to
milk
redo make this level another time.
Cold.
Hey Boyd, why are you trying to burn down the asylum?
I am the milkman. My employer has commissioned me to deliver this milk to whitewash what went on here. I make sure no evidence is left of anything except for milk. I cannot rest until I have made my final delivery.
And you'll recognize, if you were watching it, then that's the exact same thing that he says in the real world if you talk to him after the milkman is released into his psyche, implying that that is basically a script that the coach implanted
in
him.
Final delivery.
Little dead girl scouts. Chances are good I'm going to fall right on my ass. Turn around, Raz, come on. Anyway, chances are good I'm going to fall right on my ass going back along here. I always suck it. I'm okay going from the library to the Girl Scout house. I generally suck at making my way back. I don't know why. Just one of these curves I usually fly off of when I jump over the electrified rail. This one right here, in fact. Woo, I made it! Still miss that guy. And I'm gonna... So all the G-men are cleared out and everything. It is now just an empty place of emptiness. you still have all your junk that you can no longer actually do anything with. There you go, dude. I'll finally give you your tag. There was one other that I am missing too, but I can't remember which one it was or where it is, so... Oh well. Oh yeah, I do need to go back into Edgar's mine one more time, because I didn't show y'all the secret garden yet. Yeah, so even with everything cleared out, Boyd is still a paranoid conspiracy theorist, and all the trees are still flashing cameras at you and everything. But he is not as bad as he was. And Boyd's more sane, even though still totally insane. Alter ego still is gone now. He's been replaced with the Milkman. And again, logically at this point in the game, since you saw him lose the Milkman persona, that should have changed back, but you can't blame Double Fine for not wanting to reset his brain cell yet again. Man, conspiracy. Let's see. Waterloo World.
Not much to do here except clean up all the.
Shush, board. And Bonaparte is officially cleared out of his mind. I wanted to talk to him, not jump down.
Cheer up, Fred. You won the war.
I know, but now I'm bored.
Mind if I hang out?
Sure. Just don't expect me to be very entertaining.
Now, if you go around down there, you can... smash stuff once more, but now it is a peaceful society of cows.
Can you believe a great battle was once fought here? On these very fields upon which you now so peacefully graze.
Sorry, Moo Cow. Not really. And even though it is now the peaceful area, there are still enemies and everything down here if you want to go down and fight. And all the figments that I missed. Screw you, dude. That has got to be kind of weird on your brain, popping up and down the different levels in there.
Man, these...
Well, we're not really going into the real world, Raz. That's a bit beyond us at the moment, your brain. Gloria, where are you at? That's Mia, Brain Tumbler, Lungfishopolis. Actually, I never did show Lungfishopolis afterwards either.
Goggalore!
Hey, shouldn't this place be much quieter now that Coach Hammer is gone?
Well, there's still some crazy Navy guys who haven't realized that the war is over, but we've got them on the run, I think. Got some really aggressive flyers at the printer right now. Should sway popular opinion our way in no time.
So you don't mind if I smash up some more tanks and planes and stuff?
Goggalore, you may smash it all. This whole area is scheduled for reforestation. Coach Cameron built this city for us. Lungfish weren't meant to live in cities.
Well, okay then. I'll bet I can save you a bit on the demolition costs.
Yeah, go nuts. You can squish people, too, if you want. My family lives in a whole other town.
Not much to do here.
Resistance member. Yeah, so poor Linda. Even after you've broken the coach's control, her mind is still a mess. One thing you're not going to see since, you know, I haven't been making a big effort to get to 100. Terrible.
Am I sure I want to do this?
Is that Linda actually used to be in a relationship with Mr. Pokilo. If you, whose name is, was it Sam? Anyway, if you get rank 100, you get a special extra scene with the two of them in Shigor. You've got to assume that was back when Linda was just a normal little tiny lungfish. Not now that she's giant.
Hey there, kid. What are you doing back here?
Well, you know, it's always good to come back to the stage once in a while to make sure you still know how to act. So why isn't the big Bonita number playing?
Oh, Bonita's gone.
What? Oh, no.
Oh, no, no. It's good. We had an amazing 60-week run, 3 sold-out performances a day, and now she's just on a quick vacation before taking the show on the road. So the company and I are just practicing some of the old material to get ready for the tour. Well, let me know if you want to run some lines or something.
Okay.
Not much to do here.
And you can look up and see Jasper is now completely gone. Hey, Gloria is free from her massive, tick-like, horrible inner critic. Lucky her. Though she still has her mood swings if you go and smack the lamp.
Doing a great job, Becky!
Aww.
It is easy to make Becky happy. Okay, then last thing we're going to do before actually finishing the game is look at the secret garden in Edgar's mind. Now that I actually have money to buy the painting that unlocks it. Doo-doo-doo. I actually have the Psy Blast charged to a very bad button for actually maneuvering while doing this, since I'm going to be using levitation a lot more in the next area. Flowering vines. Now we're going back to where the collie was. Not here. Okay, so this little alley here where you get to, which you get through the sewers if you haven't already unlocked the shortcut like I did, is where you put up the tangled vine painting. Or as the Dalmatian says, the painting of the hair that grows on a trucker's back. And here you find where all of the dudes went when you defeated them, the Lynchshore guys. Their private hobby is gardening.
Hey, I just think it's great that you took that ass-kicking I handed to you and turned that defeat into something positive. Like gardening.
None of them will have any conversation with you or anything. They'll just... Raz will say the same thing to all of them, and they'll grunt at him in reply. He has a very, very destructive little mental vault in here. And here's where we get to see how Edgar's relationship with Lana first started out. So unlike most of them, where the harder to find one tends to be the more depressing of them, and Edgar's it's actually pretty cute, showing how his relationship with Lana got started back before she dumped him for the head cheerleader. And I suppose that even though it's the less, it's the better memory, it makes sense that it's the one that he'd hide away more, considering how that relationship turned out for
him.
Man,
these things smell terrible! Am I sure I want to do this?
Fairly pathetic that a relationship
I'm
from
ready.
High school was enough to drive him nuts for all of these years, poor guy. Well, I shouldn't just say the relationship from high school. It was bad and all his teammates turning on him and everything, but still. Okay, so now that you have seen all the extra scenes there are left, it is time to go into Meat Circus and finish the game. Stop, stop, stop. I don't have your tape. That's the fortune teller that's in front of you that's talking. If you still have any cards or anything left over, or if you have, she'll spin spider webs into cards, she'll turn cards into sign markers to rank you up. If you were carrying around any brains so they weren't there for Sheik to take back to the main area, she will get those collected for you. Just so that since you can't go back into the main campgrounds, you're not totally fucked over if you've been hoarding
stuff. You gotta help me save the bunny! If he just holds still, I could catch him and hide him from my dad! He runs a butcher shop. He wants to make food out of them.
Oh, that's right. Mari's old man was a butcher. It looks like your childhood memories of the circus got all mixed up with his childhood memories of his dad's butcher shop.
My memories were bad enough. This is just gross.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to go into a circus like that.
You'd better keep that kid out of trouble. With your brains all scrambled like this, what happens to him happens to you.
Those guys aren't hard at all, but as you go through the level, every time he gets his rabbit, little Oli flies up to another platform. And I was trying to grab you, dude. Actually, let me see. See, just even the smallest toss will kill them. But if Raz has a far way to get to a little Oli and, fucks up his jumps more than once. In the PlayStation version, you will die fast because of that. So your goal at this section of it is just to let the Oli get to his bunny.
Oh, I got you, Mr. Bunny!
His bunny doesn't actually seem to like little Oli that much, considering that it continuously runs away from him if you don't grab it. I was trying to grab you, not this.
Help! Ow!
Yes, I hear you, kid.
Ow!
This hatbox needs a hatbox tag.
Bun, bun, bun! Here, bunny, bunny, bunny!
Don't run right into that thing, little Oli.
Don't run, or else Daddy's gonna kill you! Oh, I got you, Mr. Bunny!
So one of the fixes made in the Steam version is that little Oli regains his health after each platform, which makes it harder to actually have him die.
My face!
That is my least favorite thing that he says. I don't care about your face, little Oli.
Ow! Ow! Ah!
The most important part of doing this bit is just to keep calm around all this. Now I need my shield.
Hey, that hurts! Hey, that hurts!
If you get too freaked out because little Oli keeps getting attacks, it'll make you just screw up more and more and more. At least that's what I discovered my first time through. As long as you don't get too worried about it, you usually have plenty of time if you're not trying to rush
not
too
me.
Much.
Grab the bunny! Oh, I got you, Mr. Bunny!
Oh boy. Of course, little Oli is dumb as hell for continuously landing on the platforms that have a meat grinder on them.
Ow! Ow! Hey, that hurts! Ow!
Ooh, did I get that one?
My face!
That was not what I was trying to grab.
Help! Hey, that hurts!
Wait, no.
Hey, that hurts!
Where I wanted to be. Now, this time around, little Oli might die. Oh well. Other direction. Now, the only way to get around on these dartboards is to shield when the knife thrower tosses at you and be in the right position so it gets into the board.
Oh, my face!
Oh, come on. And there he goes. Yeah, what weird glitch is that crap, man?
Ow! My face! Hey, that hurts!
I'm not wasting time with you, Mangled Bunny.
Oh, I got you, Mr. Bunny!
Ow! My face!
Spin.
Hey, that hurts! Help!
I'm coming, Sprite.
Hey, that hurts! This the smart way, and actually have the shields and telekinesis on two different buttons. Being one of those ones where you have to like strap yourself in and my face! Help.
Ah! Okay, let's see if I can actually
get out. My face! Ow!
Can't get a good grip.
Okay, let's try this again.
My face! Ow! Hey, that hurts! Ah! Hey, that hurts! Ow! Ow!
There.
My face! And keep in mind while watching this that this is the easy version of this pit. Here, bunny, bunny, bunny! Please, Mr. Oh, I got you, Mr. Bunny!
That is always those knife throwers that really screw me up, though. Oh, that thing's still floating in midair, slowly flying around.
Oh, I got you, Mr. Bunny!
This hatbox needs a hatbox tag.
Raz. I can't control you in the camera face the wrong way.
My face! Ow! Hey, that hurts!
For the other one to come back.
Hey, that hurts! Hey, that hurts!
I know that it hurts. It's your own fault for landing on the platforms that have grinders on them.
Oh, I got you, Mr. Bunny!
Today.
My face!
Oh, did you actually just help me, game? Thank you.
Ow! Ow! Ow!
And it took me long enough to realize that the game had helped me. Didn't actually help in the end. Bunnies going fast. Going too fast because I keep almost running off the ledges trying to hurry up. Or actually running off ledges and falling
apart. Here,
bunny,
bunny, bunny! Oh, I got you, Mr. Bunny!
You would have quit by now. Oh, this is nothing compared to my first time through. It's easier to stay, it's easier to stay less annoyed about it when I know, yes, I can do this eventually.
Hey, that hurts! Ow! Ow! Hey, that hurts!
Keep your momentum going, Raz.
Ow!
But there is good reason that Little Oli is probably the most hated escorty mission in all games by people who have played it. Helping kid, I'm just failing badly at it today.
My face! Hey, that hurts! Ow! Ow! My face!
of her stone.
Help! My face! My face!
Okay, now let me make this a little bit easier on myself.
Help! Help!
Come on, where is it?
Hey, that hurts!
Find up wrong.
My face!
The knife throwers won't throw at you as long as you're invisible, thankfully, which does make this bit a bit easier. And this is, thankfully, the last of the platforms.
Oh, I got you, Mr.
So now,
Bunny.
After failing and failing and failing, I just need to meet up with him on a safe spot. What I'm aiming at with the No, I want my dictation now. I can't remember if I can make myself here. That's good. I don't think I can. Can I? Yes, I can.
We did it! We saved all the bunnies! Now it's time for the main event!
Come on! I saved one bunny. Most of the bunnies went into the meat grinders. Yay, survival! For all that Oli is horrified by this, his dad is a butcher. It's,
Oh, come on! This is my favorite ride!
It's almost certain that his dad was raising those rabbits for meat, so you can't really blame him for butchering one of them.
Watch it!
You can blame him for the fact that he picked the runt of the litter to eat, but probably wanted to save the ones that had some nice meat on their bone for actually paying customers. They can eat the runt at home. The tunnel of love. Yes, and sadly for all that I failed at the getting little Oli bit, this is the part that I'm worse at. Let us shortcut this. Let's see. What do I want to aim for down there? No, other way, other way, other way. You need to run that
this
whole course to get all the figments
test.
And everything, since I am not worrying about getting all the figments and everything. You can just cheat your way through the tunnel of love. Now our first boss.
Help! Help! You've got to help me protect the bunnies!
Hey, little Oli. It's okay. Those monsters are gone now. The bunnies are safe. We're all safe.
No! It's not safe! He's coming!
Who's coming?
My dad!
Your dad? The butcher?
He says little bunnies are good for nothing! Nothing but food!
Here, little bunnies. Don't run, or else daddy's gonna kill ya!
Yeah, Oleander has some major daddy issues. So does Raz, but Raz is 10, so... Yeah, I think a lot of people lost all their lives for the first time, Crab Man. There's a reason that Meat Circus is known for being redonkulously hard. I was actually supposed to jump over.
Bun, bun, bun.
I was trying to shield there. Yep, so you have to get his cleaver stuck in the ground, and then you get a chance to whack at him. The ground, if you notice, bleeds. It is. Well, I'm using the shield here. Most of his attacks you can jump over with the levitation ball. You have to time it right. Now we get to Raz's daddy issues.
What's going on here? What have you done to our circus?
Dad!
Polluted. Perverted. This looks like the work of mentalists.
I can explain.
Have you been associating with psychics?
Dad,
Psychics. Fortune tellers. They killed your grandfather. They cursed our entire family to die in water.
Yes, but...
Including you, Rasputin. And me. But I'm going to live. You know why? Because I'm still an acrobat. Let's see if you are. What's it going to be, son? Die in the water? Or show me what you got?
So this is the part in the game where your acrobatics actually become important. I am facing the wrong way, aren't I? So off that trampoline there, is it?
There you go.
It's not like my fault there. We try. Diving into the water.
That's beautiful.
Is it this trampoline here, Crab Man?
Pretty good. Pretty good.
He's not letting me punch at all when I jump off.
Face up! Catch! Dig fast! Here comes the water, boy.
Oh, that one. My better, smarter move.
Remember your trick. Come on, son.
for anybody who's not looking at the chat who is wondering what I'm talking about here, I've been getting it.
Up here!
I'm trying to do a glitch that one of the other people watching is telling me about. But I'm not having much luck with that.
Maybe
I just psy-palmed the water instead of the trampoline.
And less time reading those comic books. Be up here by now.
Hey, this has nothing to do with comic books. It has to do with me trying to get a glitch going.
Quick! Up here! Before the cold, clammy hand of fear pulls you under. Come on, son. You used to like to play catch with me.
Well, I finally got to the right trampoline and dove right through the edge of it.
Rasputin!
So at least I won't be trying to side punch the wrong trampoline.
Here comes the water, boy. Now you can't really catch those. It's just testing.
Okay.
Quick! Up here! Before the cold, clammy hand of fear pulls you under.
Try going on that one more time, but it looks like it's not working out for me.
Up here! Come on, son. Here comes the water, boy. Let's see if you remember your train.
Now, clearly at this point, Raz has just decided to commit suicide. It is not my doing.
Maybe there's better time practicing your acrobatics and less time reading those comic books. Be up here by now. Pretty good. Pretty good.
I'm too much.
Up here!
Well, it looks like it's still not doing anything with the double jump other than making me go really high.
Rasputin! Incoming!
I'm afraid after a dozen deaths, I'm gonna have to give up on trying that, Cranman. I'm sorry.
You used to like to play catch. Incoming! Good! Pretty good!
This bit right here is where a lot of people complain that their double jump stops working when they have to get between these bits.
Sweet.
Usually, if it does fail, you can use Sky Float to get between them if you're careful with your game. Oops.
There you go.
Rabbit Raz, yay! I almost missed that one. Let's line this up properly and go. Now the flaming hoops. Apparently Raz is a
lion. Hey, babe, you spent more time practicing your acrobatics and let you used to like to flip cats. There you go. Hey, son! Catch! Think fast! Good. No, you can't really catch those. That was just testing. Here comes the water, boy.
By the way,
you always were a slowpoke. There you go. You used to like to play catch with me. Now you can't really catch those. It's just a test. Now you can't really catch those.
If you look, the bubbles actually have meat in them, too.
You used to like to play catch. Think fast!
Actually,
there you go.
Drop down onto here. I'm gonna go invisible for this bit so
hey,
it stops the
catch.
At me.
Pretty good. Pretty good. Incoming!
Yep. Invisibility can be really, really useful during this level.
Come on, son. There you go. Now you can't really catch those. Just
should we jump when I tell you to jump, Raz? Actually, don't go down there. Go over this way. If I don't fail to jump. If you climb down the ladder the way that it seems to want you to, you'll end up climbing straight into the water. It's
you
a trap.
You used to like to play catch. It'll help. Hey, son! Catch! Think fast! There you go. Now you can't really catch those. That was just testing. Babe, you spent more time practicing your acrobatics and less time reading those comic books. You'd be up here by now. You always were a slow one.
Yeah, I'm sure Toby Anderson said to Dad.
Now you can't read.
You should just go ahead and change my name to Slowy Joey.
Incoming! Pretty good. Pretty good. Hey, son! Catch! You used to like to play catch with me. Here comes the water, boy.
Yes, I see the water.
Dig fast! Hey, son! Catch! Incoming! Here you go!
I'm rather more worried about okay. Here comes the fire that's been hurting me a lot more this time around.
You used to like to play catch with me.
Is that real time to make this?
The water, boy. It'll help.
That time I should have made it. That time I am not taking credit for. I am fully taking credit for the fact that most of my deaths this time have been me being a dumbass.
Good. Pretty good. Incoming. Hey, son!
That one I had the jump button on at the right time. Should have.
No, you can't really catch those. It's just test. Better help. Think fast! You used to like to play catch. That's pure think fast! Here you go.
Like I said, if you look down, the water is right on the axle of that ladder. If you climb down and then climb back up, he will just end up killing himself by climbing into it. But as long as you side-float over to the next side of it, you can stay ahead of the water. Just keep pushing up no matter how much it twists and turns. Everything's getting buried. Somehow the fire is staying lit even as it gets under the water.
Dad, I made it!
You cheated!
No! I used the acrobatics you taught me!
Don't lie to me, cheater! You crystal ball readers always cheat! You're no son of mine!
It is cute how proud Raz sounds of himself that he made it up there himself. Though since I did use psychic abilities,
oh,
he did cheat
okay?
by his psychic
Where's your dad?
Stand.
He's over there, talking to your dad.
He did what?
Uh-oh.
Somebody's going to get grounded.
Make that ground.
Rehash of the butcher fight, except this time there is the idea of the mental figment of your own dad sucking things at you. Oops. And a big old butcher. A sausage grinder dealing in the middle of the screen. This time you do not want to. Oops. This time around, you do not want to climb up his hatchet when it gets caught. Because if you do, you will get lit on fire.
Incoming!
Here, bunny, bunny, bunny.
There you go.
Into the grind with me. That's their horrible noises.
Rasputin! I see your skull is as hard to penetrate as ever.
Dad!
What is your brain doing out here in this tank with this other brain? And who are all these unconscious people? What have you gotten yourself involved with, psychics? He's been cavorting with filthy, cheating psychics! Is that really how I look in your mind?
Oh,
man, do I hate psychics! And seeing my son happy. I don't hate psychics. I used my psychic connection with you to find you, and to project myself into your mind.
But how can you hate me for being psychic? If you're psychic too.
Son, I could never hate you. I only wanted you to be happy, Rasputin. And safe. Our family has many enemies. I have a lot more hair than that. Now, son, we have to carefully unweave your psyche from that other brain. We don't want anything bad to happen while your mind is in this tangled state. The damage could be permanent. Unweave? Detangle?
Never! I like it this way. I mean, look at how huge I am! And I think I can juggle now.
This is your mind, so you are the strong one here. What I'm about to give you, my son, you must take care of it, because it's everything I've got.
Oh, you're back to Gagalore sizes. So for the final battle, really all you do is punch, punchy, punch, punch.
Hey!
Do I have the wrong thing? Yes, I do have the wrong thing there.
Come here, little bunny.
When you're small, there's nothing you can do to them. You just have to wait until you get big again. And then punch, punch, punch.
Don't run, or else Daddy's gonna kill you.
And there's that little meter in the top right corner that shows you how long it is until Raz is fully powered up again.
Come on, son.
Really, it's fairly appropriate that Raz's last fight involves him just punching the hell out of the boss. It's like I pointed out way back at the beginning. The only psychic power he really starts out with is his Psy Bomb punch, that and his double jump. So he's pretty much finishing the game with the only ability that came naturally to him. Kind of. With adding bad power to make it huge besides.
No more meat. Look.
There you go! Good little bunny! Hey, thanks for helping me save the bunnies. And for talking to my dad.
No problem, little Ollie.
Bye-bye! Wave goodbye, Mr. Bun!
Where's he going?
We're separating the brains now, Rasputin. He'll be fine. Let's go inside.
Man, I can't wait to tell you about all the messed up stuff that happened.
Oh, I know a lot of it. While you were out, I poked around a bit. Tell me about this lily person.
Hey!
Okay, let's see we're going up.
And so, that brings us to the end. Where, as you can clearly see, the personal demons causing my negative behavior have all been eradicated, leaving me sane once again. This is also corroborated in CAT scan number 3 on page 59 of your handouts. On a personal note, I would just like to reiterate how extremely, extremely sorry I am for stealing all of your brains and trying to take over the world. Mistakes have been made. But this camp is all about education. And I know I, for one, learned plenty. Thanks to that guy right there. Come on up here, Raz!
We endeavor to build strong minds here, with the power to lift things, to see things, to burn things. is. But it's a special quality of your heart, not your mind, that truly makes a great psychonaut. This young man has it. We did not give it to him. He got it from someone else long before he came here. But we can give him this to honor his mind, his courage, and his heart. Son, we do not normally ask this of someone so young, but it is obvious to us all that you are not average. Will you join us, Rasputin? Will you be a psychonaut?
Perfectly clear about this. That was the best summer of my whole entire life.
Hey, the summer's not over yet. We can hang out for a couple of weeks still.
My family's out on the East Coast. Where's yours?
They move around a lot.
Well, you'd better go. Your dad's waiting for you.
Well...
Bye.
Children, it's an emergency. There's been another kidnapping.
I was here the whole time. You saw me.
No, this time we know who it is, and that's what scares us.
Who was kidnapped?
Truman Zanotto, the grand head of the Psychonauts.
Dad!
Sir, can you teleport this many of us back to headquarters?
Huh? What? Hey, what are you people doing in my kitchen? Now get!
Guess we're taking the jet.
Pretty neat little detail. If you look, the jet is being carried around by a Psy hand. It's not actually flying under its own
Don't
volition.
Worry about your dad, darling. We'll get him back.
Yes, after all, we'll have Rasputin helping us.
I'm going?
Now how could we do this without our anti-kidnapping specialist?
I've taught you everything I can, son. Now, you go show them. Show them all.
Let's go.
Like I said in chat, because I didn't want to talk over the main or the ending scene, if you kept an eye on the outhouse when it changed to the parking lot for a split second, you could see the original main character, D'Artagnan, peek out of it and then duck back in. As Crabman said in the chat, that was changed because he was wearing like a long stocking cap type of dealio that they just couldn't get the flow right in the game, so they changed to an easier-to-animate character. As TV Tropes puts it, his hat was too awesome to animate. You can just fast-forward all of these to look at the pictures. Raz hanging out with Rudy. He looks kind of stoned in that one. Mega sensor came back just for photo. Hey, Linda. And if you assume these show things that actually, you know, happened with him taking pictures after the game, it shows that Crispin and Dr. Lovato did survive. Though that's, you know, fairly unlikely on Dr. Lovato's case, since he got blasted up top of the tower. And here, both boys are existing at once. Crispin, we have no idea what happened to him. He just got stuffed somewhere by Fred after Fred was done with his nap, and then the asylum exploded, so we don't know if he was caught in the explosion or if he got away or what. And another clue that this isn't actually happening is Jasper being back and with the Phantom. There's the one that is my image on my screen when it was, when it's, nothing's playing. I was gonna start out with the one that we'll see in a second with all the campers, and I thought, nah, this is a let's play, let's go with the one where they're playing the game. I still always love the colors in Black Velvetopia. It is so pretty. Oops, there's your last glimpse of all the campers. And that's Ranger color. There's the Double Fine team. So this has been Psychonauts. Thank you everybody who joined me for it. This is, like I said when I started, this is my favorite game ever. I got it, I think, a year after it first came out, used, and I liked it so much that I have bought it like a billion more times on Steam. I bought a Humble Bundle just because it was in at Xbox. I keep throwing money at it whenever I have a chance, just because I feel guilty that I got it used my first time. Tomorrow I'll be starting a new game. Yeah, it will be a surprise to me what it's going to be too, because I haven't quite decided yet. There's a few things that I'm trying to decide between. I might go Double Fine again and do the cave run through of it. If I do, it would just be one run through, not showing off all the different characters. Because that game does get pretty samey after a while. Each character has their own area, but the places between the characters' areas don't change from playthrough to playthrough. I might do, I just got the game The Road Let's Take In. I might do a blind run through of that at least to start, but I am pretty horrible at roguelike, so probably won't see the end of it. Or, I have been thinking of doing a couple other old favorites of mine, Bastion or Alan Wake. Like I said, we'll see you tomorrow. Thank you everybody for joining me, and I hope that you had fun. Bye.